morning. All right, can we go to the grass, please?
Good point. I'm just standing here in the middle of nowhere.
So we're at this truck stop that I was telling you about yesterday. This little, tiny little truck stop. And they got this weird, creepy little open area right behind the truck stop here. So we figured we'd go and take a walk. There's a nice little creepy path down there.
I came out here to walk Diesel last night, and it was pitch black. Wow. Just thinking to myself, man, this is a creepy place at night. It's a good place to die, you know? This is where people take people when they kill them and hide the body.
It's like a train yard over there.
I don't know. We're gonna go explore this path a little bit this morning, though. My truck is just right over there on the other side of these long bushes and grasses. Oh, I'm still waking up. How was your night, everybody? Did you guys sleep good? If you're on the other side of the world, have you had a good day? You get a lot done at work? Hope you didn't slack off all day. Just kidding, I know you didn't.
Oh, that's weird. I need a tower like that at my house.
Yeah. Because I'm putting a tower on top of my house, right, with a cell booster. Because there's no cell service there, or very, very, very little, because there's so many trees and bush. So we're going to put the tower on top of the house. It'll go above the trees, and then I'm putting the cell receiver, or whatever you call it, at the top of the tower. Why is there something on my ear? Weird. Felt like there was a bug crawling on my ear. Yeah, so hopefully I'll get a good cell signal inside my house then.
Turn that. Diesel will be happy. You'll have all the room to run around. You'll have friends next door.
That's going to get annoying, I know. I'm going to either have to put up a fence or something, because I know the neighbor dogs, he looks like they stay tied up, but I'm sure he doesn't keep them tied up all the time, because it's the country, and who ties their dog up in the country? No one does that. So he probably just tied him up when I was there. Meaning that Diesel will have like freedom to run around with them. And you know what happens when kids get together? They get carried away, they start playing, and before you know it, they're 2 miles away, stuck in a hole or something, or... See, I'll have to figure something out about that so that they stay on the yard.
That's what it's called, Phillips 66. This little tiny little truck stop here.
That's where we're at. So we're gonna go deliver our freight right now. We've already got a reload going straight back home. The load's going to Edmonton, I think, but I'm taking it home. And then once I get home, we're going to Vlogger Fair. I just got a little bit excited there. All right, guys, I'll go deliver this freight and I'll see you after.
It's kind of a shady area of town here. I'd show you where I was, but just in case they watch my videos, I probably shouldn't. This is where I'm delivering, in Kansas City. It's a little bit shady here. You know, I was talking about that creepy, shady area behind the truck stop there? It just got shadier and shadier. Lock the doors.
I'm not afraid or anything. Like, it's broad daylight, but this isn't exactly the neighborhood I would want to be in at night. Remember last night I was saying that I might come right to the customer and sleep here in the truck on the street right where I am right now? And I'm glad I didn't. Really glad I didn't. I think I mentioned that last night too. I said sometimes I do that, but sometimes it bites you in the butt because you go to the customer and the customer is in a sketchy area. And then you end up getting your truck vandalized or worse, you know, during the night. You don't want that. But maybe it's not that bad of an area just because I'm not familiar with it. I don't know what it would be like at night. I can't really judge it. That's why I don't want to show it to you. I can't judge it, right? But just first impression. Creepy. So they told me to wait out on the street. And they were gonna come get me, and then we're gonna get unloaded, and then I gotta go about 45 miles to my next pickup. And once I'm loaded, I just head straight back, and it'll take me about a day and a little bit to get back, so probably about a full day today. I'll be back tomorrow sometime. Well, it's tomorrow. Tuesday. Well, that's good. Then I'll be home a long time Wednesday. And I leave on Thursday. But Wednesday I have appointments at the bank to do some signing and stuff. So Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, and Monday afternoon I can leave again. So we're just gonna hang out here in the truck and chill and wait for them to come get us.
Okay, we are unloaded, we're empty, we're nice and light. I feel light as a feather after getting all that heavy weight off me. Oh man, I just feel like going really fast all of a sudden. But we won't. Speed limit. So we are headed over to Sedalia, Missouri. Not too sure where it is, but Mandy does, so following her advice and headed that way. We're gonna pick up a load there, like I was telling you. It's gonna take us home. We should get a long ways home today. We should get really close to home, and then it'll just be a short drive tomorrow. And that'll be that. And then it's time to get ready for Seattle. I believe it's almost time to move. Wow. What's this guy doing just walking down the road? Dude, this is a road. Okay. Alright. Guess I can't say I've never done that. Well, we're loaded in Sedalia, Missouri. Did I say Kansas before? Sedalia, Missouri.
So the state fair is in town here in Sedalia, Missouri. And I'm curious, what happens at a state fair? Is it like a fair in Canada? Like, is it sort of like the Calgary Stampede? Or is it more like the Red River Exhibition? I know those mean absolutely nothing to you living down here. The Calgary Stampede, there's like amusement rides. There's rodeo, horse racing, chuck wagon racing, a whole bunch of horse events, bull riding. You know, a rodeo. It's huge, huge. 50,000, 100,000 people there at least. I don't know how many people go there. In Manitoba, we have the Red River Exhibition where it's mostly just amusement rides. That's the fair. Oh, I need to get over one lane. Oh, that guy's gonna let me in. Nice people, you know, every once in a while you meet the nice driver who realizes your turn signals mean you'd like to turn. Anyways, off topic. So, what happens at a state fair here down here in Missouri? How many of you go to the state fair? You know, I always hear about it on TV, and it's people always joking around about it that all the rednecks show up at the state fair. Now, I don't know if that's true or not, but I think I get that from Larry the Cable Guy. He's funny. But, it's the same thing in Canada. Yeah, you'll find every redneck and their 20 cousins there. But, let me know in the comments, why do you go to the state fair? What brings you in? What draws you in? What lured you in? It looked like a lot of fun. There is a ton of people there. Police everywhere. Oh, yeah. It was a pretty big event. I saw a bunch of horse wagons. That's why I'm wondering if they have horse races. Yeah, let me know down in the comment section. Let me know what state you're talking about. And then let me know what happens at that state fair. And how often is it? Is it like once a year? Or is it all summer? Or is it all year round? I want to know. Let me know.
Look how nice and mowed the truck stop is. It's a little windy over here, but... Very nice, we're at the Pilot.
Apparently they have a McDonald's here.
Oh, it's bright out here. Diesel, where do you want to go, buddy? Want to go down here?
I don't want to go to the long grass, man. I swear to God.
Good boy, that is his bush. That's a very nice bush, Diesel. Good choice.
I would have picked the same one.
Grasshopper just landed on his nose. That's funny. So we are in Higginsville, Missouri. We're finally all ready to go, ready to rock. Took all day to get unloaded and reloaded. And now
letting Diesel drain himself, and then we're gonna go inside, get something to eat. Probably not at McDonald's, but maybe. You never know. I haven't had McDonald's in a very long time. Don't judge me. Then we're gonna get on the highway, and I've got some new music that I've been trying out, and I wanna try it out in the next scene a little bit. I wanna show you the road a little bit. I know a lot of you like that. A lot of you like that sped up sort of tour version. So we're gonna be leaving Higginsville and going through Kansas City and then headed up north on the I-29 towards Canada.
Alright, decent.
You wanna drive for a little bit, man? Cause I'm tired.
Alright, maybe you could have slept longer, man.
Wish I could. Okay, guys. Let's get back on the road.
All right, so we went inside. We decided to go with the Subway sandwich again. For one, I like Subway. And two, it's better than McDonald's. Those are the only two options I had in here today. We need to go to Walmart. I'll do it eventually. Probably do it after this trip. I'm not even gonna bother because I'm gonna be home tomorrow anyways. So no point in stocking up my truck when I'm not gonna be in my truck for the next weekend anyways, so we'll do it after. Whoa, and it's gonna be good. I got that pulled pork. It was so good yesterday. I had to try it again today. Oh, it's delicious. Have you guys tried it yet? I think it's called the Applewood Pulled Pork Sub at Subway. If you haven't yet, and you're going by a Subway, try it out. I think it's only in the States though, because I couldn't find it in Canada. I'll probably come to Canada later. That's how it usually happens.
Celsius. It's about 80, 85 Fahrenheit. Sunny, partly cloudy.
Run 284 kilometers on I-435 North.
Gladly, Mandy. I would love to drive 284 kilometers on I-29 North. I'd love that. That's what she said, right? I-29 North? I don't know. I-29 North. I don't know. We're on the I-29. And thank you so much to KK Penner Tire Center, who fixed my truck. His riding so smooth. I guess the real reason I'm so happy that it's fixed now is if it wasn't the tires that was causing my truck to shake and vibrate, we're talking big money to figure out what it was. So thank God it was just the tires, because if it's the transmission or the engine, or anything else, it costs big money to do all kinds of tests to figure out what's shaking. So we're doing good right now. Let's hope the shake stays away. Let's hope it doesn't come back. Let's hope we killed it for good. And now we can just enjoy our ride home. We are 1,300 kilometers away. That's 13 hours of driving.
Hit stop at the rest area. Very nice rest area it is too.
Isn't it, Diesel? Isn't it? Very nice. What's up with your ear again? Why does it do that sometimes? Hey, why does it do that?
I like it that way, man. It's hip. All the kids at school are doing it, man. They're all wearing their ears this way.
Ah, that's a cool thing to do.
Alright then.
Well, I just heard the terrible news about Robin Williams. I know this is a week late for you guys, and I don't mean to it back up again for you, but I just literally heard the news that he was found dead in his home. They're saying it's looking like a suicide. I'm hoping by the time that this video right now that I'm making is published and airs, that maybe they could have proven that it wasn't. I'd like to think that he didn't go out that way. I know that he struggled with a lot of things in his life, but I really didn't think it would come down to this. Robin Williams is like my one of my number one favorite actors. It was always him and Jim Carrey. Jim Carrey is still with us today when I'm filming this, so I got one favorite left, but I grew up with Robin Williams, like in Jumanji, in Mrs. Doubtfire. There's so many good movies that I loved with Robin Williams in it. If you told me about any movie that I didn't think was very good, and you wanted me to go watch it, all you had to say was Robin Williams was in it. I'd be there. I'd still to this day, if I heard Robin Williams was in something, I'd be there. Still seems like surreal or like not real that he's gone.
Well, it's that time of day. We're at a rest area just south of Sioux City on the I-29 northbound. And we're gonna hang out here for the night and get a good night's rest. We're 9 hours from home, so we'll be able to get home tomorrow. We'll probably be home tomorrow afternoon then. Well, I don't know if you can see that in the video. You can't really. Stars are kind of beautiful today. A lot of light pollution, so it's hard to see them. I can't wait to move. Did you know that tomorrow, I can say that the day after tomorrow, I fly away to Vlogger Park. I'm gonna be on a plane in the sky, man. Like I was saying yesterday, did I cut that out? No, I think I left it in there. I've never actually been on a passenger plane before. I have flown a Cessna, but I've never been on a passenger plane. I'm really excited about it. As you can tell, I keep talking about it. Diesel, enough talking. You need to do some business, man. Why are we on the concrete, man? You can't go on the concrete. Man, get in the grass there, man. Get in the grass there. Atta boy. Good boy. Oh, wait. Oh. Okay. You gotta stop the flow before you start walking, Diesel. He gets it all over himself. Oh, so it was a good day. It was a really good day. Can't really complain. Have nothing to complain about. Beautiful weather. Beautiful. Like when we were going through Kansas City there, oh, it's just perfect. You know, it's been a beautiful, clear night. The moon is out over there. You guys see that full moon yesterday? I guess it was over a week ago for you. Just amazing. I love summer. I say this every day pretty much, but I love summer nights. Hey, Diesel, you want this post? Oh, Diesel found something. Hey, what'd you find, man? What'd you find? What is it? What is it, Diesel? Hey, leave it. Let me see it. Now you scared it into the shadow, the poor little guy. Hey, little guy. Anyone come out here and play? What is it? Diesel, leave him alone, man. Hey, he's a little frog. Look at him go. Hello, frog. What's your name? Yeah. No, Diesel, we don't eat the frogs. I just want to play with him, man. Dude, you're like 100 times his size. You're going to squish him. Look at him. I want that frog, man. I don't know if he wants to eat him or play with him. Right now, he just wants to stare at him. What is that, Diesel? What is it? I don't know where he went. Oh, man. You cannot have the frog, man. He really wants a frog. We will let the frog live. It's your lucky day, frog. You always do that, Diesel. You always go the opposite way that the leash is going, you know? Does your dog do that, too? You know, you're like holding the leash with your left hand, but he insists on walking on your right side every time. Oh, okay, Diesel. There's a flower here just for you. Just for you, man. Do it. Yeah. That's your flower, man. Watch, that flower is going to be blooming like it's never bloomed before.
Give it a couple days. You can thank Diesel for that.
Good boy.
Yeah, man, just doing my part, man. Just trying to keep everything beautiful, man.
Yeah, so, Diesel, can I please just walk? You're being really rowdy tonight.
Really rowdy. That frog just got them all riled up.
Speaking of frogs, I saw a documentary the other day on these huge toads that they got out in Australia. Is it Australia? Yeah, I think it's Australia. They have these huge freaking toads there. And they're not native to Australia, right? They were brought there to try and eat some kind of beetle, but it failed, and now they're taking over one part of the island. Massive suckers! Like, they're huge! Like, you don't step on them, they step on you. That's how big they are.
Hey, Diesel.
Well, we're gonna end the vlog here, guys. You know what to do. There's a lot of links down below, like I was saying before, to past videos of mine. Go check them out for a little bit more Trucker Josh if you want to. There's also a lot of other links down there. Just go to the description box and see what's all there. There's a bunch of new stuff. I will talk to you tomorrow, just like every other single day, at 4 a.m. Central Time, right here.
Say goodbye, Diesel. Say goodbye. Why didn't you let me play with the frog, man? I'm upset, man. This is my mad face.